see. This is up. So we can talk about extract and all about speed.
Oh yeah, and they're poor Sandra. Oh, she's okay. Oh, being savaged.
Oh no.
Oh honey.
Not good. Mix 107.9, 80s, 90s now. That is Pink and Sober. 8:26. Good morning. Happy Friday. We head into the Labor Day weekend. New movies opening in Columbus, Ohio theaters this weekend. And we're going to take a look at those movies right now with the Mix Flick Chick, Kelly Gingery. Good morning.
Good morning, Mark.
So we're going to talk about two.
Yes.
Two new flicks. Yes. Okay. Which one do you want to start with? All About Steve?
Start with that. I was going to start with Extract because I saw that one.
Okay.
All About Steve. They didn't screen.
No, no.
And I think for the reason that we've talked about before.
Not seeing very good reviews about that.
No, so we'll get to that because I have some thoughts on that. But Extract is Jason Bateman.
I saw the clip for this when we went to 500 Days of Summer, yeah. and it made me want to see it.
Yes.
The clip made me want to see it.
It did, and I'll tell you, let me be honest.
Uh-huh.
The clip has good stuff in it. This, I wanted it to be funnier.
Oh, okay.
You know, it's what I call small funny, not big funny.
Right.
You know,
it's belly laugh funny.
Exactly. It's not laugh out loud like The Hangover or something, these big hits that, you know, are just outrageous.
Right.
And Mike Judge, the guy who wrote and directed it.
The Beavis and Butthead guy.
Yes, Beavis and Butthead, and also Office Space, which is a huge cult hit from about 10 years ago.
Uh-huh.
He does situational humor, and the humor comes from the characters and the writing, the dialogue. It's not, you know, crazy outlandish situations, really.
Okay.
But in a very tiny nutshell, Jason Bateman owns an extract company that makes like vanilla extract and that kind of stuff.
Okay.
And so in the workplace, you got all the crazy people working on the line. You got the managers that don't like the crazy people. And so a workplace accident happens to someone, and he's got to deal with these crazies. And like the lawyer that comes in is played by Gene Simmons. You know,
from Kiss.
Yes.
Oh, wow.
And so he's like the guy on the billboards, you know, I'll get you your money, and he's funny, and so everybody has. But Ben Affleck plays Jason Bateman's buddy.
Okay.
And he's like a stoner bartender guy.
I didn't even recognize him because he has this big, like almost like a ZZ Top beard.
Yes.
Not a ZZ, like a mountain man beard.
Yes, mountain man, and the hair, wavy hair. He is funny.
Okay.
And he just together they're funny. And Jason Bateman, he's the perfect straight guy. You know, he's very snarky, but not in this movie, not so much. He's the guy that everything's happening to, and he has great, like, slow burn reactions and stuff.
Right, he's like the Mr. Normal guy,
and
he's just kind of like, he's just, life is dull and a drag, and his wife, there's no romance there, and don't they have, like, I remember, like, the office hottie temp girl.
Yes, Mila Kunis.
Temptress.
Yes, Temptress, and she's got a whole situation, too. She's kind of a con artist, so she's kind of funny, too. So everybody, and there's a neighbor that's always bugging him when he drives home, you know, and he wants to get in the house. So they're a very funny, but like I said, it's funny, but it's not the funniest movie I've ever seen, but it's not meant to be.
So
it's got mixed reviews because people that like my judge, and that they're like, oh, it could have been better.
All right.
I think people wished it could have been better.
Okay,
but
so you're...
I thought it was funny.
It was funny, but you wished it would have been funnier.
Yes.
Okay, well, there you go. All right, let's talk about All About Steve.
Oh, my goodness, because I'll tell you this. The critics are talking about it.
Yeah.
Sandra is being savaged by the critics, and I don't usually read, but read a headline. I know you're looking at it right now.
Yeah, the headline in the Dispatch, Bullock bombs in witless comedy.
Oh,
so
honey.
They didn't screen it, and maybe that's why.
And here's the deal. I'm going to give you quickly about this. The Proposal, which that's one of the first movies you and I talked about when I first started.
Right.
That was an unexpected, huge hit.
That's
okay?
Right.
And I got it right here. It cost $40 million to make. To date, in 10 and a half weeks, it has grossed $270 million worldwide.
So you think they rushed this one out to capitalize on that?
Yes, they rushed it to the marketplace. This was made before, okay? Because guess what? What I also want to touch on is also the guy in it is Bradley Cooper, who is in The Hangover. That movie, guess what? That cost $35 million. Guess what? That's grossed worldwide.
So this could be a situation where they weren't even going to put this out, and then the stars got hot,
yes!
So they put it out. All right.
So totally. The Hangover grossed $420 million and cost $35 million. So, I mean, they saw these two. It fell in their laps, the studio. They made this movie, and it's a dog. I hear it's awful. And so they made it, and then these two get hot. They have this huge hits in the summer, and they're like, they weren't going to release it till March, this All About Steve.
Okay.
And they said, get it out at the end of the summer when these two are hot.
Make a buck or two.
And maybe if people, unwilling victims, will go sit in the theater.
So don't fall for it, people.
Uh-uh.
Uh-uh. Wait and rent it, and then, you know, or borrow some from somebody to rent.
Here's what I recommend. Read what the critics have said about it, because it's funnier than the movie.
Okay.
One guy said, this is for a movie that only people that think, I'll be watching you. What's that Sting song? That they, if they think that's a love song, this is a movie for them.
Oh, yeah.
Because she stalks this guy.
That's a song. Okay.
All
right. So, okay. All right. Well, thanks, Kelly.
You're welcome.
You provide a fabulous, wonderful, valuable public service.
Thank you.
Appreciate that.
I think Sandra's going to send something to me in the mail, and I'm not going to open it.
We love her.
I know.
She's
I do.
Better material.
I love her.
All
I
right.
do.
Mixed Flick Chick, Kelly Gingery. We podcast her movie reviews at mymix1079.com. We'll talk to you next weekend.
Yes, you will.
Gin Blossoms, Hate Jealousy at 831, Mix 1079.
I was going on and on again. Sorry, I know you were wrapping me up.
Oh, no. Well, I saw we were coming up on 5 minutes.
Oh, yeah. Shoot.
That flies, doesn't it?
I know. I feel like it's got, like a minute and a half.
Yeah. No, that was great. That was awesome. And I think one of the best things we do is everybody's going to go see some of the Hugo movies, you know, no matter what. But
uh-huh.
I think that we steer people away from, you know, movies that they might waste their money on.
Right.
And point out movies that people might not consider.
Exactly. Like 500 Days and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I mean, because I really do think The Extract, it wasn't a bad movie. It was just, I really was sitting there going, oh, it's funny, but I wish it was funnier. Because when I saw that trailer, I thought it was going to be hilarious, you know?
Right.
So I was semi-disappointed, but, you know, I love Jason Bateman, so.
Yeah.
He's awesome.